clicking on my video and coming here to watch what I have to share with you today. And today we are doing another unboxing and reveal. And I decided that I wanted to buy another Louis Vuitton bag. I did do a lot of research on this item, and when I decide on the bags right now, I look at what I have, what I need, what can replace each other, because I don't want it to get wild and spread and too much. I'm building a collection which serves different purposes and will last me hopefully the rest of my life, and where I don't need to buy again next year. That is the goal. And so I was deciding between three bags, because I have a few Speedies now. I have the Noé, Petit Noé, and so on. I might do later on when I'm finished a whole collection video, but I was looking, just to explain how I decide my purchases, I was looking what I have, what I would like to have. If I saw a bag, can a bag that I have already replace it? Like, for example, right now I was looking at the Neverfull, at the Graceful, and the bag I bought now. And the Neverfull I omitted because I just love my MCM list bag, and I thought really hard about it because the Neverfull is a very good bag. It's at a moderate price point. You get the pouch, you get the bag, and a lot of people love it. But I was looking at my list. I really took my time to make my decisions for all of the Louis Vuitton purchases, because those are investment purchases. Not investment because I want to resell. I don't sell my bags, but investment in the sense of that when I invest the money, I want to get a lot of use out of my bags. So I decided if I have the Neverfull there and the MCM, I most likely will always grab my MCM list totes, and so it would just sit in the corner. So I omitted that. And I also did something. I carried my list for a few days to think, and I decided no Neverfull for me.
But all that doesn't mean that I will never ever look at the Graceful again.
The Graceful is still to 40 to 50% in the back of my mind, but I like bags with zippers. And if you watch my videos, you know that I recently purchased the Odeon MM. And the Odeon MM is only 1 inch off the Graceful PM. And I bought a shoulder strap for the Odeon, and it looks really like a nice hobo bag on me too. And I put the Graceful aside, and now we are coming to what I actually bought. And it came just now. UPS just delivered it to me. And my address is here, so I ripped that little part here off. And I'm opening the flap because my credentials are on there. It came, I ordered it yesterday, it came today, and I will show you the bag, and I will show you also a few mod shots with it at the end of the video, so please stay with me. So this is the receipt, and I'm taking you down with me now so that we can open the bag together. Drum roll. Always so exciting. Can you guess what it is? Can you guess? What do you think what it is? Leave me a comment now. Leave me a comment what you think what it is, and then continue watching. It is the Alma BB. Super, super smooth. The strap is inside. The lock. This is the pouch for the lock. And I think it has also the tags in here. Yeah. The Alma BB is never on the website, I can tell you so much. I looked at it for a while, I never saw it online. And this piece is made in France. I don't know if you can see that. I will insert a picture later. It's hardly visible here. And don't know what these two spots are, but it's brand new for sure. It smells brand new and it's beautiful. I love it. And now I will attach the strap. This is the clochette. Let me see if the keys are inside. Yeah, the keys are in here. And I'm not sure if this is meant to be like sticking out here like this. It's super soft. I saw so many reviews that, not that it is sticking out. The reviews I saw said that it sticks out like this at the beginning. And once it gets softens up with use, then it becomes softer and goes down. And I'm excited to see how the strap hangs on me. That was my major thing I was thoughtful of. So we will do that now together again. So I wanted to show you quickly, there were these two little dust particles. I just took them off with the dust bag. Actually, I just rubbed the dust bag a little on the particles and I started inspecting the bag actually. And I'm looking at how even this line is, because I watched plenty of videos and they told me, some of the videos said that this bottom line of the leather is uneven, and they said a few bags were like wobbly. So we are doing the test now. If it stands properly, it stands properly. The bags they were showing in the videos were like falling over, but this stands like totally nice on the feet. And what I was also looking at is the zipper. The zipper is completely nice and straight. Everything is aligned nicely. The stitching looks also perfect. So that's the bag, and now we are attaching the strap and looking at some more shots. So the strap is non-adjustable or anything, but it is at least removable. It's not like the Nano that you cannot remove the strap. So you can use also if you have the Speedy Eben or any other strap you want. So let me see how that looks on me. This is like a shoulder. Crossbody is perfect in my opinion. And this is top handle, and I think I like it best as a top handle. And I will do a what fits at a later point. I love the reinforced feet. The hardware is super shiny on this one. And on contrary to the Speedy, the hardware matches. It doesn't have like the Speedy. I have my Speedy here actually, not the Damier Ben one, but now I have a different strap on the Speedy, but on the Speedy, this hardware is different than the strap hardware. And here it's all matching. And I'm super happy that this is super even. The stitching is nice. The bottom looks nice. The zipper is super smooth, like super smooth. And yeah, super beautiful bag. I love it. And when I do my what fits, I will try to show you also how it looks with the shoulder strap. The shoulder strap, then the back will look like this, which is also super nice and cute in my opinion as a shoulder. And yes, let me know what you think about the Alma BB. I watched plenty videos. A lot of people have a love-hate relationship with the Alma BB, but I love it. So let me think what you think. Let me know what you think, and if you have one, let me know how to get this a little bit down, because this is sticking out a little weird. Look, but I'm sure there's a way to do that. And I hope to see you in my next video, and stay happy, stay healthy. And I'm a little out of my mind because somebody is walking in the back in my backyard and I'm home alone. It's a little spooky, but that's why I'm a little irritated and confused. But I will take care of that in a minute. Alma BB and Reshmi go along very well. So I have to go now. See you in my next one. Bye.